Hey, after yesterday's video, I tried to create another idea inside the grid, and my initial idea was, would it be possible that I can create an grid graph that can generate presets for the polysynth? And you actually can do that inside the grid, and I want to show you how you can do that. And if you take a look here at the grid, I chose an poly grid, and inside the FX section I have a polysynth. And inside the grid itself I have a lot of modules and trigger. And I play you a sound, and the sound is completely generated via this graph here. And every time I press basically this trigger, every parameter inside this polysynth is changing to another value. So let's push it and play again. Different sound. I push again. Different sound. Not so good. Okay. Maybe add more reverb to it. So I use my reverb preset. Not so bad for random generated content, I think. And I used for this a random modulator here. And then a trigger to trigger a sample and hold module and some delays. And my thought was that I used a random modulator, which generates basically a sine wave. I can show you this in the oscilloscope here. Just create a sine wave. Well, you can see it here in this section. And with delays, I delay this output about a certain amount of time. And I've chosen 25 Hertz, and I calculated that I have to choose 40 milliseconds each step to get another cycle of values, basically. So to speak simple, I output random values in a kind of sine wave type of style, and then I sample every 40 milliseconds I sample a value, and this value goes into this sample and hold module. And when I trigger, I have on each line a different value, and this different value is going to this modulator out. And with this modulator out, I chose one parameter of the polysynth and some value for the modulation amount. So in case of the pitch, for instance, here I have chosen not to modulate too much, just a little bit, because the sound would become too much out of tune, right? So I've chosen some ranges that make sense in a preset. Yeah, that's basically it. I duplicated every of this line and added 40 milliseconds with each step. And yeah, it's going down. And yeah, I have 6 batteries of this. And I modulate basically different values inside the polysynth. Every time I push the trigger button here, I generate new collection of values. Apply that to the polysynth and have a new preset, basically. And this is pretty nice when you have no idea or just want to have a random sound or preset. Every time you press, you get completely random sounds. Not so completely, they are still audible, right? And yeah, all we all I want now is basically that I can go to the polysynth and click with the right mouse button and say apply these modulator values or convert these modulator values to real values, so actual knob values, if you know what I mean. So because now we have just applied some modulation here to each of these knobs, and I can't say save me this preset because it's just modulated. I need an option inside polysynth where I can say convert me this type of modulation as a real value into the polysynth, and then we could say yeah, let's save this as a preset. And this would be pretty nice because you can generate so much presets that you like, push just the trigger button, and if you have a sound that sounds pretty nice, you save as a preset and you have a new preset for the polysynth. And we can basically do this for all kinds of synths and also VST plugins maybe. This would be a pretty nice, interesting way of generating a whole lot of presets. And yeah, I share this preset for the grid with you. I put it in my GitHub repository so you don't have to do all the hard work. And it's actually a pretty easy setup. But yeah, it works just fine. I think it's very great. Yeah. That's it for this video. I hope you like it and add me some questions, comments, and yeah, maybe I do another one tomorrow. See you. Bye.